Here's another article from our website that I think maybe you'll enjoy. Evolutionists claim that many viral infections and earlier life forms have resulted in the DNA of those viruses being passed on ancestrally in later evolving organisms. One example of the failure of this claim is that the PTERV1 is found in the rhesus monkey, olive baboon, and African great apes, but not in humans. This makes it clear that the ERVs are evidence of common design, not evolution, since had man and the great apes shared a common ancestor, the great apes would also share the PTERV1 with humans. 14 of the so far discovered 98,000 human ERVs are found in the same location in the human genome, in chimpanzee genome. However, this means that 99.99986% are not found in the same location. Okay. What are called retroviruses are transposable elements of DNA, which means that they are capable of jumping around the genome and performing various functions. Endogenous means that they are produced or synthesized within an organism, and retrovirus means the sequences in question are claimed to be remnants of viral DNA acquired by infection in evolutionary ancestors. However, PTERV1 is such a sequence of DNA that exists in old world monkeys and chimpanzees, which are claimed to be man's oldest living, closest living relative, and yet they don't exist in humans. If it were retroviruses, then the DNA sequences should be found in humans. The Human Genome Project has verified that what evolutionists once called junk and retroviruses are involved in controlling the sequence of level of gene expression during embryonic development by moving to and from the sites of gene control. Are interdependent with other portions of the DNA, function as promoters by starting transcription at alternative starting points, enable different RNA transcripts to be formed from the same DNA sequence, aid in the transcription of 1/5 of the entire human genome. Okay, consider that. The list of specific functions for what are called retroviruses is now so extensive, time doesn't allow me to even mention them all. The sequences called retroviruses are at the heart of genomic design, morphological design, biochemical functions of creatures, and have been discovered to be elements of intelligent design and powerful evidence of a common designer. The Human Genome Project report states, quote, "We report the existence of 51,197 ERV-derived promoter sequences that initiate transcription within the human genome, including 1,743 cases where transcription is initiated from ERV sequences that are located in the gene proximal promoter or 5 untranslated regions." That's a lot, okay, of common design. It also states, quote, "Our analysis revealed that the retroviral sequences in the human genome encode tens of thousands of active promoters, transcribed ERV sequences corresponding to 1.16% of the human genome sequence and PET tags that capture transcripts initiated from ERVs cover 22.4% of the human genome." Wow. Okay. You think viruses do all this in a human being? No, I'm sorry. The evolutionist is therefore stuck with believing that 23.6% of the human genome is comprised of viral DNA. How preposterous it is to believe that the instructions in the human genome could be comprised of so much viral DNA, considering that humans are intercellular creatures of incomparably greater complexity. Evolutionism is quite obviously so irrational and so far from having basis in science that evolutionists must rely on conclusions not unlike believing that the instructions to build a portable radio could comprise over 23% of the instructions to build a personal computer. Regarding the junk DNA claim, and I mentioned this because, you see, much of this, these retroviruses and pseudogenes that evolutionists claim are evidence of ancestry between man and other creatures of different phylum exists in the area of the genome that evolutionists once called junk, but we have discovered now it's not junk at all. In fact, I made a prediction about it 3 years ago to certain evolutionists that we would discover that much of this DNA was information stored and retrieved later during morphological development of the human being, and I was right. Regarding the junk DNA claim, Dr. John Maddock, director of the Institute for Molecular Bioscience in the University of Queensland, who is an evolutionist, by the way, has stated, quote, "The failure to recognize the full implications of this, particularly the possibility that interleaving non-coding sequences may be transmitting parallel information, may well go down as one of the biggest mistakes in the history of molecular biology." In fact, the Human DeEncode Project has determined that 93% of the human DNA is transcribed into RNA. See, the junk retrovirus and pseudogene claims of evolutionists have fallen short. They've been discredited. The Human Genome Project alone has done so. Referring to the DNA and to junk DNA and retroviruses, molecular biologist Linda Walkup has stated, quote, "The molecular taxonomists, that's those who believe that phylogeny is evidence of ancestry between different phylum and of creatures, okay, through evolutionary ancestry." Okay, she states, "The molecular taxonomists who have been drawing up evolutionary histories or phylogenies for nearly every kind of life are going to have to undo their years of junk DNA-based historical reconstructions and wait for the full implications to emerge before they try again." See, the Human Genome Project has discredited all these claims regarding retroviruses and pseudogenes and whatnot, and phylogeny even. Clearly, what evolutionists once declared was junk DNA and what are claimed to be retroviruses are now known to be similar sequences of DNA in different species which provide similar or identical to identical clinical functions. But evolutionists don't like the embarrassment or giving up their claims, despite the fact that the Human Genome Project has discredited the evolutionist claim of junk DNA and retroviruses and pseudogenes as evidence of evolution. Science Daily still has on their website an article published from 2005 which states, quote, "Much of the rest of our genomes, often referred to as junk DNA, consists of retro elements. Human endogenous retroviruses make up most of those retro elements." See, in 2005. That's just 5 years ago. Look what they're claiming. See? Been discredited. YouTube user Don Exodus 2 states regarding retroviruses in his video titled, "This is why every scientist accepts evolution, which is false. In fact, if the truth be known, most scientists don't believe in evolution. Most of them are afraid to state so, that they either doubt it or don't believe in it because they know it would be the end of their jobs, because secular humanists, atheists, evolutionists control the peer review process and academia, so they won't speak out about it. Some have and lost their jobs for it." He states, Don Exodus 2 states in that video, quote, "Phylogenetic trees can be reconstructed from them alone." He also states, quote, "This is why every rational person must accept evolution," in regards to retroviruses is what he's talking about. To which I ask, based upon what? Antiquated assumptions based on an evolution paradigm which have been discredited by the Human Genome Project alone? Like all evolutionists, he's promoting antiquated assumptions as if they were science. Creationists predicted that what was claimed to be junk DNA and retroviruses would be revealed as having being elements of a common designer, have critical function, and be part of what separates us from each other, and we were right. The Human Genome Project has discovered this very fact. Though still using the claim are uninformed and an embarrassment to evolutionists, the now discredited retrovirus claim is a fine example of how evolutionists adopt remarkable elements of common design into their paradigm, stamp the word evolution on them, and then think this makes their false assumptions into science.